We thank you so much for joining with us. Our purpose here tonight is twofold: to celebrate the success of our growing foundation, thanks to the generosity of each of you, and secondly, to honor a gracious lady, former County Commissioner Pat Glass, by awarding her the Senator Edgar Price Jr. Lifetime Achievement Award. Pat Glass, yes, you can applaud. And I want to read something that I think will give you just a taste of what to expect later. Pat Glass has been such a wonderful influence on my life, as many of you. But Larry Ann Harris, a departed county commissioner who was a good friend to all of us and a good friend to Pat, she wrote this letter to her on June the 14th, 1999, just before passing away. I want to read it to you. "Dear Pat, you've been such a treasure in my life. I have often said that you are the First Lady of Manatee County, and I have meant it sincerely. How to begin to thank you for all the love, friendship, and mentoring you have given to me these years past. I admire you so greatly and have learned so much from you. I know of no other with such grace, style, wisdom, compassion, and vision. Your friendship has been so very precious to me, and I have learned so much from you. We sure have shared a lot, haven't we? Wins and losses, happiness and heartache, births, deaths, divorces, marriages, jokes, and insides and cappuccino. What a combination. Through it all, I have known I could always count on you without fail to perk me up, lift me up, and make me feel special. You make everyone feel special. That's one of your best talents. Thank you for the memories, my friend. I love you dearly. That to Our Lady, Pat Glass." So who are we, and what is this foundation? The Family Healthcare Centers of Manatee Foundation is an independent philanthropic organization committed to supporting Manatee County Rural Health Services in its effort to promote innovations in care and to assist in broadening access to health care. The Family Healthcare Centers of Manatee Foundation's mission is to expand access to affordable quality health care for underserved individuals and communities, and to promote fundamental improvement in the health status of the people in the Manatee County Rural Health Service area. The foundation goal is to ensure continued financial viability for Manatee County Rural Health Services, ensuring that there are dedicated funds that are available for services in the event of reduced or terminated funding. To ensure funding for capital projects and services and our programs that are not covered by traditional funding sources. And of course, you're familiar with Manatee County Rural Health Services. It's a private, not-for-profit, primary and specialty care network. Manatee County Rural Health Services was established in 1979 by a group of visionary community leaders. The purpose is to provide outstanding patient care based upon the principles of cooperation, compassion, and innovation. And the guiding principles of Manatee County Rural Health Services is that every person residing in the service delivery area, regardless of race, sex, color, nationality, language, origin, economic status, or disability, has a right to access primary health services and preventative health education. This may come as a surprise to you, as it was to me 2 years ago when I had the great honor and fortune of joining this organization. Today, Manatee County Rural Health Services is the largest community health care center in the southeastern region of the United States. Now, the Manatee County Rural Health Board of Directors will be introduced a little bit later by our President and CEO, Colonel Mickey Preche. And I have the great fortune of working closely with the Family Healthcare Centers of Manatee Foundation Board, which is comprised of professionals from our community. Allow me to introduce them to you. If you will stand as I call your name, hold your applause. Senator John McKay, Mel Klein, John Fitzgerald Jr., and Tim Vining. Would you please stand? And then, of course, our board chairman, person that has taken on this responsibility and has the interest in what we are trying to accomplish. It is my pleasure to introduce the chairman of the board, Mr. Jerry Neff. Jerry.
Thank you, Sheriff. You know, I've known him so long, and he and I used to have dark hair. Okay, good evening. Tonight we have the privilege of honoring former Manatee County Commissioner Pat Glass. What could be more appropriate than to recognize Pat by presenting her with the Senator Edgar H. Price Jr. Lifetime Achievement Award for her many years of service to Manatee County and to our state? Before I mention some of Pat's accomplishments, I want to tell you about the success of Manatee County Rural Health Services in 2008. Manatee County Rural Health operates 19 healthcare centers serving Manatee, Sarasota, and DeSoto counties. Patients are cared for by 76 medical providers with 14 medical specialties, 7 pharmacies and telepharmacies, and 425 employees. Over 81,000 patients were seen with nearly 350,000 visits last year and were treated for medical, dental, mental health, chiropractic, vision, and podiatry services. As Charlie mentioned, he stole my thunder. In fact, Manatee County Rural Health is the largest community health care center in the southeastern United States. It serves the community with in-kind medical, educational, and community service programs, and it is supported by the Family Health Care Centers of Manatee's Foundation. Your attendance here tonight and your generous contributions to the success of this event support the foundation, and you have our heartfelt thanks for that. We thank you for assisting us with the future financial soundness of our organization. Now back to our honoree. In 1978, Pat was elected to the Manatee County Commission, and she served numerous terms for nearly 3 decades until retiring in 2006. I asked her a few moments ago what she wanted me to say about her, and she said, 1, don't sue me. 2, don't vote for me, because she's not running for anything. During her tenure, she served several times as a chair, and she was an active member in the Manatee County Port Authority. She was the chair of the Manatee County Commission. She also served on the Tourist Development Council, the Sarasota Manatee Metropolitan Planning Organization, the Tampa Bay Regional Planning Council, the Civic Center Authority, and on and on and on. Pat, I got a question for you. How many meetings have you attended in your life? Quite a few. Needless to say, Pat has a lifetime record of exceptional commitment to and generosity for our community. She's shown outstanding dedication and self-sacrifice to the people here in Manatee County. And she's been a leader through numerous charitable, civic, educational, and community-based organizations. She has had a profound impact upon the growth and the prosperity in our home, Manatee County. Commissioner Glass, thank you for all that you've done and continue to do for the residents of our great community. We sincerely appreciate you and your longstanding dedications to the citizens of Manatee County. It is a pleasure for us to give you this special recognition tonight that you so richly deserve. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. And we have, first of all, let me say to you with all sincerity that we are so appreciative of each and every one of you that has come here tonight and had supported this organization and supported this foundation. And we have others that are, we will give special recognition to. We worked on them, our getting our public officials and our community interested in what we are involved in. And with your tolerance, I would like to please introduce some of them. And hopefully, I've got all of the names, but fear not. We will check during our break and during dinner to make sure we don't miss anybody. By the way, Congressman Vern Buchanan is unable to be here tonight because he's in Afghanistan, but he did send us a sponsorship for tonight, and we deeply appreciate that from Congressman Buchanan. Senator Mike Bennett, if you're here, stand up. I didn't see some of them. Senator Mike Bennett? Okay. I know former Senator Pat Neal is here. We would like for Pat to stand up. There he is. Thank you, Senator. State Representative Ron Reagan. State Representative Daryl Rusan. One of my favorite people, Circuit Judge Lee Hayworth. Judge, thank you very much for being here today. Another judge, Rochelle Curley. I know she's here. Where are you, Judge? There she is. Thank you. Another buddy of mine, City of Palmetto Chief Gary Lowe. And ladies and gentlemen, the guy that took my job, Manatee County Sheriff Brad Stubbe. Thank you, Debbie, also for being here tonight. Brad's wonderful wife. We appreciate it. Sheriff Knight called me, and he was scheduled to come. Then he was called out to another appointment. Steve Burns, his undersheriff, and his friend Leslie is there. Thank you very much for coming up from Sarasota. Thank you. Manatee County Commissioners, Carol Whitmore. I know she's here. Thank you, Carol. Gwen Brown, Commissioner Gwen Brown. Commissioner John Chappie. And an aspiring Manatee County Commissioner, candidate Robin DiSabatino. Robin? Mayor of Palmetto, Shirley Groover Bryant. Thank you, Shirley. Mayor of the City of Bradenton, Wayne Poston. Now, some of these guys are obviously unable to make it, but they sent their money in. That was sweet of them, wasn't it? City of Bradenton Councilwoman Mary Ann Barnaby is here. Saw her. City of the Bradenton City Councilman Harold Byrd. Former Manatee County Commissioner Stan Stevens, County Commissioner, excuse me. Thank you. Now, John Saputo, you here? Did the Colonel make it up? I was hoping he would make it. He was nice enough to sponsor a table here tonight. So even though he isn't here, we'll give the Colonel, who is a genuine fighting machine, U.S. Marine Corps Colonel John Saputo. Give him a hand. School Board Chairman Barbara Harvey. chairwoman, excuse me. We have Johnny Hunter, the publisher of Tempo News. And we're also appreciate the Braden and Herald sending reporter Jennifer Rich to cover this event. Thank you, Jennifer. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I would ask you to stand for the Pledge of Allegiance, followed by the singing of God Bless America by Zelda Mercado and Willie Calhoun, and then invocation by Bishop Lawrence Livingston. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Zelda Mercado.
God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above. From the mountain to the prairie to the ocean wide with foam, God bless America, my home, sweet home. God bless America, land that I love, stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above, from the mountain to the prairie to the ocean wide with foam. God bless America, my home, sweet home. God bless America,
and if you happen to see Saisha on American Idol, this is her mother. Bishop Livingston.
Let us pray. Good evening, our Father, our Redeemer, our Sustainer. We invite you into the presence of this very fine gathering tonight. You are the Holy One. You have redeemed us through your precious sacrifice and trust. We trust that beyond absence, there is presence, that beyond pain, there can be healing, beyond brokenness, there can be wholeness, that beyond the anger, there can be peace, that beyond the silence, there can be thy word. That beyond thy word, there may be understanding. That through understanding, there may be love. Father, because you love us with eternal agape love, we ask in hope tonight for your presence to flood our hearts with the fellowship of love, kindness, and benevolence given by the Family Health Care Centers of Manatee Foundation. Therefore, we give thanks. We acknowledge that you have blessed our community so richly with health care teams that are unknown or unheard of in so many places. Therefore, we give thanks. Please give us the gift of wisdom and patience, and give us loving hearts that shall always be quick to help and sympathize, and slow to hurt and criticize. Finally, we ask for your blessings for the food and nourishments that we receive tonight, and we ask it in the matchless name of our Lord, and we all say, amen.
A couple of more introductions that I overlooked, and I told you that we probably would, regrettably. First of all, let me introduce to you school board member and good friend, Harry Canan. Harry, are you someplace there? Thank you, Harry. Thank you. Dr. Utley with the Huntington Healthcare Group, one of our sponsors. Hi. Okay, and the president of the Manatee County chapter of the NAACP, Ed Bailey. Ed? And if I may, for just one moment, I want to recognize these people. Most of you know that for 41 years I was in law enforcement, and they're my best and special friends still to this day. And I introduced the sheriff and his wife, Debbie, a little bit earlier. But I want to introduce to you a person that was my personal assistant. She still remains personal assistant to the sheriff, and her sweet name is Cynthia Lorraine. Stand up, baby. Stand up. And all of those sheriff deputies and personnel at that table, I thank you so much for coming tonight, and I love all of you. I still get choked. And my buddy that's going to join our foundation board, the incredible, longest hitting softball player in the world, Bruce Mead. Stand up, Bruiser. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, it is no accident that Manatee County Rural Health Services has been such a success, but rather it has been by design. This organization has experienced growth from years ago in that old historical schoolhouse and parish to what it has become today. The success has been because of a dedicated and committed board of directors and to its chief executive officer, Colonel Mickey Preche. I have known Mickey some 25 years. He's one of my best friends. Nobody has more energy. Nobody is more devoted. Nobody is more knowledgeable about the healthcare profession than Mickey. He is a true professional. I've watched him up close. He cares about his employees, and he cares about the patients of the organization he commands, the ones that they serve. Mickey has had a long, impressive military career. He fought for his country in Vietnam. He escaped death many times fighting that war. He saw many of the GIs under his command lose their lives. But I believe I can state without fear of contradiction that that war and that incredible service that he performed made Colonel Mickey Preche the man that he is today. That incredible drive he has, that courage he possesses, that discipline he maintains, some, if not most of it, was derived from the battles he fought defending the freedom of all of us. When I retired from public office, I was honored that Mickey allowed me to become part of this organization. He's a pleasure to work with, and his leadership is evident in everything that exists in Manatee County Rural Health Services. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce the President and CEO of Manatee County Rural Health, Colonel Mickey Prichet.
Thank you, Charlie. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank all of you for coming tonight to honor two of my most favorite people in Manatee County. Before we get into the occasion, I want to make sure that I introduce Manatee County Rural Health Board of Directors. Please stand and be recognized for serving and receiving those big paychecks every month. Chief Gary Lowe is our chairman. Ms. Wendy Laurie, who I'll talk about a little bit later. Mr. Willie Weems. My good friend Reggie Ozarko, Mark Lazarus, and Dr. Lynette Edwards, Assistant Superintendent, Division of Curriculum and Instruction for Manatee County School Board. I'd like to recognize a few special guests seated at my table. Senator Ed Price. And his guest, Ms. Barbara Ann McKinney. Nick and his wife, Deborah Kotesh. Nick is the president of WDG Construction and one of our platinum sponsors. Thank you very much for you and your wife being here. Attorney Jonathan and Amy Fleece. Jonathan is the chairman of the Healthcare Committee for the Chamber of Commerce. Thanks for coming with your lovely wife, Amy Fleece. Dr. Gladys Brannick. One of my very special colleagues, retired director of Manatee County Public Health Department, a unit. And of course, Ms. Wendy Laurie again, who's served on our board since its inception. I want to acknowledge the senior leadership team of Manatee County Rural Health Services. Will you please stand to be recognized for all the great work that you do on behalf of the board of directors, the staff, and all the patients we serve. These guys are the frontline guys. Thank you very much. Also, I need to do a special recognition of two people without whom rural health could not function effectively. The special assistant to the president and CEO, Ms. Silvio Camerani. And our Vice President of Medical Affairs and Medical Director, Dr. George Van Buren. Finally, a special recognition to our event team, led by Vice President Ellen Adams and Marketing Director Shawnee Roby. It is a pleasure to see so many of you in attendance to celebrate, and honor Pat Glass for all the great things she's done for the citizens of Manatee County, the Tampa Bay area, and the state of Florida. As usual, on this kind of event, my staff wrote some notes to follow. However, I don't need any, because the two people that are here to recognize and honor tonight have been good friends of mine for decades. Senator Price, for whom this award is named, and the special person that will receive the award, former Commissioner Pat Glass. Tonight we celebrate the second annual banquet named in honor of Senator Edgar H. Price Jr. Sir, it has always been and it remains a great pleasure to honor you and especially to be counted among your special friends. You are my hero. Thanks so very much for all you've done and continue to do. Okay, to the person we are here to honor tonight, Pat, a very special lady. Pat, as you've heard me say so many times before, just about everything that has been established as public policy and serves, quote, the public good, end quote, has your name attached to it. From protecting the watershed, establishment of Port Manatee, the former Sheriff Charlie Wells Hotel, that's now Sheriff Brad Stubbs Hotel, to the creation of the corpus from the sale of Manatee Memorial Hospital that led to the establishment of the Indigent Healthcare Trust Fund, the establishment of senior citizens transportation, legal aid for seniors, weatherization of homes for the conservation of energy, and the expansion of one of our most popular programs in the community, Meals on Wheels. Pat, your service to our community is virtually unmatched. For those who do remember, Pat was the director of the area-wide agency on aging. Pat, when we were both younger and very enthusiastic, and as I grow older, my enthusiasm sometimes wanes. But in the case of you, Pat, everybody who's here tonight knows that your enthusiasm just continues to multiply. Also, for those who remember, there was a time when Manatee County did not apply for federal funds. Therefore, our neighbor to the north, Hillsborough County, always applied for and received those monies that were appropriated and allocated to Manatee County. This all changed when Pat became the director of the area-wide agency on aging. She made sure that Manatee County got its fair share by expert negotiation, making a call to appropriate power brokers, begging, badgering, or beating people across the head, whatever it took. She ensured we got our fair share. Pat, you have been intimately involved in the development of our infrastructure of all our county, and you continue to dedicate yourself to service to our community. I could list a myriad of things that I can't go on as I vow to stay on schedule. Finally, there's an old saying that behind every successful man, there's a strong woman. But in this case, behind this successful woman is a strong man, Hank, Pat's husband. Thank you, Hank, and family for allowing Pat to have the time and the resources to volunteer, to lobby, to run for public office and win, and to serve the citizens of the great county of Manatee. Finally, Pat, it is our great pleasure to honor you by dedicating this event to you this evening. Thank you for all you have done for us. You're very special. Thanks again for being you. You are indeed a very special lady. Now we will introduce the video, which is done expertly by the great Charles.
Anytime you talk about Pat Glass, it always revolves around the same thing, leadership and a commitment to Manatee County. I know Pat Glass as a wife, a mother, a grandmother, an elected official, a water expert, but more than that, I know her as my friend and a friend of so many people in Manatee County. When Pat Glass walks into a meeting, the entire meeting lights up because of her knowledge, her understanding, her commitment, and her ability to achieve her goals. You know, as we walk down this pathway called life, Pat has glowed so brightly that she's left a pathway for others to follow. You know, some people walk into your life, others walk out of your life. And then there's people like Pat Glass who leaves a footprint in the hearts of so many people.
I'm so happy to be here today to honor a friend of mine, Pat Glass. She has been a remarkable leader in Manatee County as a commissioner for almost three decades. That's incredible. She's the first woman to be chairman of the Board of County Commissioner. What a leader, what a pioneer for women's rights. She has been so heavily involved in community social services with the AIDS Council, health care issues, family services. The amount of knowledge and care and dedication that Pat has for our home, our community, is unbelievable. I've gotten to know Pat over the last 4 or 5 years, and she's become a very good friend and a mentor to me. She's really set the standard for what an elected official should be. You know, Pat always seems to know the right thing to do. She's a remarkable woman, a remarkable leader. I want to thank you for myself and for all of Manatee County.
One day in the summer of 1977, I met this new lady from Cleveland. She had a brand new degree in gerontology. I think she worked for the Tampa Bay Regional Planning Council. That day we had breakfast at Denny's at 7:30. Of course, I was 25 years old. I had a vanilla ice cream with chocolate fudge. I think she just had the regular breakfast. But what we had in common is we both wanted to change the world in a good way. Manatee County was different at that time, and she was new and different. She had different ideas. I don't mind saying that she changed the consciousness of a lot of people. She was a building block of my life, but she changed things in Manatee County. Having been elected first in 1978, she knows everything about our county, everyone here, what they did, what they're interested in. What she has given Manatee County is a continuity of policy, which we have here in Manatee, unlike any other community where I've worked. What you've done for me is raise my consciousness, integrate me into the community, work hard on projects with me, but most of all, you've been my friend for all these years. So thank you, Patricia, for Manatee, but mostly thank you for all that you've done for Pat Neal.
What a pleasure it is to be here to speak to you tonight on behalf of Patricia M. Glass, Manatee County's very best friend. It's so easy to call her that because I doubt there's a person watching or in this room who hasn't experienced firsthand the miracle of knowing her. There's not a cause she hasn't been called to, a person she hasn't befriended, a call she hasn't taken in the middle of the night. Pat is always there for everyone in Manatee County. I suspect her reach extends even beyond our community. So while I'd love to continue to talk to you about the many great things she's done, I know you probably have read about them in the newspapers, seen them on TV, or even seen her resume. So I would just like to address a few comments directly to you, Pat. I thank God for you. You are an inspiration, a person who lights the way. You are spectacularly beautiful in your person. You have been your whole life. I suspect you were the most beautiful baby ever born. But to see you and to know you is to also see that there's a light that shines from within you that is a showstopper. Who can look at you and not just stop what they're doing, from the youngest to the oldest person in a room, and look at you and say, my goodness, you are a beautiful soul. God bless you and thank you for so many things that they are too many to number. We love you.
No one in this county deserves this award more than Pat Glass. I know from personal experience working with her for many years. When I was a young nurse at Manatee Hospital in the 80s, I sat in the audience during the negotiations with the county and the hospital to sell the hospital. And the hospital encouraged employees to go there to kind of pressure the county commission. Well, I sat up there and I watched Pat Glass in action. She was the only female. And I remember at the last meeting when the vote finally happened, looking at everybody in the audience and thinking, you know, I want to be like her someday. And I worked for many years. I met Pat through various friends, and we've been friends for approximately 20 years. We go out together. I've learned so much from her. I was in politics since 91. She helped me out in the islands when I was an elected official. And I just want you to know, Pat, that nobody deserves this award more than you. You have done so much for Manatee County, and I'm eternally grateful for all that you have done for me and this county. And I just want you to know we love you.
Each time we ran up against an obstacle, she was the one who came with the common sense of telling us how to do this with a never give up attitude. Now, you're talking about a person who is a fighter, she's a fighter. She takes on those unbelievable issues that are not popular sometimes with your constituents, but you know it's the right thing to do. She takes those kind of issues on. And that's what makes her remarkable. I've yet to hear her say one time that something cannot be done. She always thinks of how we can do it, how we can make it better. And to me, that brings about a very special person. You have truly been blessed, and this community have been blessed for having a Commissioner Pat Glass as part of this county. I wish you the best.
Everything Pat does is with style, elegance, and grace. Her accomplishments are taken for granted by many because she is truly an unsung hero who never takes credit for what she's done. One night, this all hit home for me. I met Pat for dinner, and our waitress introduced herself. She wanted to thank Pat for helping her family. Betty's son had AIDS, and when he lost everything because of his illness, he came home to Manatee. Betty nursed him for years, and when the AIDS Council was started, he became a client. She had tears running down her cheeks as she told Pat about his last days and how much the AIDS Council had done for both of them. He had just died. She was grieving terribly. Betty was so grateful and knew it was because Pat had the strength and courage to take on a cause no one else wanted. That's what Pat does best. She follows her heart and isn't afraid to do something that is unpopular, but she always does what she feels and knows is right. That was an experience I will never forget. Pat, you're a great friend, but most importantly, a terrific mother, fantastic wife, and loving grandmother. To Hank, Michael, Mary, Marty, and Diane, thank you from all of us for sharing her. And thank you, Pat, for being my friend as well. We all love you.
Hi, Mom. I'm so glad to be here tonight to be able to congratulate you on such a lovely evening. But I especially want to thank you for being the best mom in the whole world. And I know my friends also say that very often, but I know our family is really blessed. I'm so glad that Mike is here and my sister Diane and Marty, and especially Dad. I'm so glad that you could be here with all of us tonight. But one of the things I know Manatee County is so fortunate, but as a family, we're even luckier. And so from the bottom of my heart, I just want to say thank you for everything that you've done for us. And I look forward to many more fun trips and shopping and all the good things that we do on a regular basis. I love you, Mom.
When I looked at the record of this year's recipient of the Life Achievement Award, I immediately came to the conclusion that every county in Florida needs a Pat Glass. This amazing woman, who is living her life to the fullest extent of her God-given abilities, whether serving in government, politics, education, culture, or in the numerous volunteer agencies, she continues to come as a worker, even though she's been a director or chairman or founder of many of these agencies. When we desperately needed help in our county to find a way to bring about better race relations and tolerance, we needed someone to come forth with an idea, and Pat formed the Judicial Council and a commission to bring this about, and she found a way and she got it done. And when we knew that the homeless situation in Manatee County was one that had to be corrected and we needed help, Pat Glass stepped up to the plate, found a way to do it, and got it done. And she got it done for the aged and the deaf, and as an advocate for children, and to help find ways to treat AIDS and substance abuse and so many other of the needs that we had in this community. And she continued to serve on these nonprofit charitable organizations in the community to get all the rest of the work done. Well, carrying this big load didn't stop her. In late years, she went back to the University of South Florida and earned her bachelor's and her master's degree in a period of less than 4 years. But this was just the beginning, because the most important thing in her life was to be a loving wife and a mother, raising 5 children and 3 grandchildren, and becoming a fantastic role model and an example not only for her own children, but for all the children of Manatee County whose hands she touched. It literally changed their lives. Yes, every county in Florida needs a Pat Glass, but those of us in Manatee County have been blessed because we have the original Pat Glass. And Pat, my dear friend, we want to thank you for all of the achievements that you've done in your lifetime, because they've affected each one of us, and we pray that the best will be yet to come.
For this year's recipient of the Edgar H. Price Jr. Lifetime Achievement Award, Ms. Pat Glass, we are going to do this as friends to a friend. So, Charlie's going to escort you up, and we're going to give you this beautiful, beautiful. Thank you. Thank you.
award.
A beautiful award to a beautiful recipient. Thank you again. Remarks like that.
This will be brief. I'm overwhelmed. And for the first time in my life, I think I'm speechless. I always worried about the sale of that hospital, and thank God Manatee Memorial's in the hands it's in today. And that rural health has sustained itself over the years, and this was the glue that kept the AIDS Council together and did some remarkable things, as Linda mentioned. There's so much there, and for the friends who really know me, they gave me a wise look when it was all over. We know you really. We know really what you do. I just have one short thing, because I had to honor, not had to, I was honored to be able to talk about Senator Price, and this is his award. And I am the first recipient of it, and there'll be many over the years. There are other Ed Prices and other Pat Glasses in this world, and a lot of them are sitting right out here tonight, let me tell you. And they don't receive the recognition they need. And if ours produces some enthusiasm in the community and some good things, then we're grateful. I have no Ed Price stories, but I really have to tell you this. Ed has always been a genuine part of this community and this state, and a standard bearer for government services and an exemplar of business ethics. And those two should never be separate. We need to keep our government and our business community and all of us together working toward a better economy today and a better life for everyone. And as I said at that time, he is eloquent, elegant, and he has a presence that celebrates that this town because it celebrates hometown heroes, occurs in particular instances, but as a role model and a mentor and real leaders and real citizens like all of you that are constant and bold participants in the hidden, and I tell you this very sincerely, the hidden and obscure corners of life, as well as the most dramatic accomplishments. So a hero may have a moment, but those who are back in the corners working do it every day. They are not the timid saint waiting in the wings on a stage for recognition, but humble servants with the strength and iron resolve to make this world a better place today. God bless all of you. My deepest and sincerest thanks to you, to Mickey, to Ed Price, to Sheriff Charlie Wells. Thank you, thank you. And to Charles Clapsaddle, whose talent far reaches beyond Hollywood, Florida. Oh, my goodness sake. And to my family, there are four grandchildren, and one of them is a boy. I don't think he was omitted, I'm sure. But I tell you, Alex, Jenna, Nikki, and Katie, the four grandchildren are great. Tonight with us, my son Michael, my daughter Mary, from whom you heard, who did a really great job putting a lot of this together for us. My son Martin Alexander, and let me see, did I miss anybody? Hank Glass is down there, by golly. Okay, did we get all the kids? I did mention Nikki. Well, Christine is my other daughter. Not my daughter-in-law, and she wasn't in any of the pictures. Now, that gives me a perfect thing. I sit on the board of leadership of the University of South Florida. 8 degrees came from South Florida in this family, and my daughter-in-law, but daughter, Christine, just received her doctorate. And so she just, stand up, Chris. See, there is a reason why God destroys short-term memories in elderly people. God bless all of you, and thank you from the bottom of our hearts.
Stand up for one minute. Help me close out.
Okay, I will.
That's good. Thank you, Pat. God bless you. Thank you. You can remain standing for as we close out here tonight. Let me tell you that we are really grateful for you being here to make this such a special night. And Mary, where are you there? Mary, when you came on that video, you killed me, baby. I don't think there was a dry eye in the house when you talked, and so special to hear you talk about your mother like that. And Senator Price, everybody knows that Mickey and I thank him for keeping us straight all those years. So to Pat Glass, God bless you, and God bless each and every one of you. If you'll look on your table, there are contribution pledge forms. We keep right on begging right to the end. And if you would like to make a donation to our foundation, we would be honored to accept. Good night, everybody.
Good job, Terry. Oh, God.